Your attention, please.
The Diz Geek Podcast.
What's up, everybody? I just wanted to do a quick recording before the end of 2018 and wish everybody a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I'm sorry I wasn't able to get a new episode out before the new year, but you know, sometimes life gets in the way and it was kind of hard to schedule at a time, you know, it's hard to schedule a time when, you know, we're all available and stuff. We were so close to recording last week, but out here in jolly old North Carolina, it snowed. And because of that, the whole city closes, basically. And my daughter, who's in a choir, her performance got delayed. And the rescheduled performance ended up happening on the night we were supposed to record. And, you know, we ran out of time. So I was hoping to get it done this week, but, you know, it's the week of Christmas. I'm actually recording this on Christmas Eve. And tomorrow I'm flying to Las Vegas for the week, and I'm not even going to be back home before this, you know, before this year is over. So unfortunately we won't be able to record a new episode before the end of the year. And so, you know, I apologize for that. But what I have is this. Connie Moreno recorded her audio reviews of some of the food items at the Festival of Holidays over at DCA. And I went ahead and put those together, and I edited and, you know, stuck them all together, all her recordings. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to play that. So, Connie, take it away.
Well, I think you can tell by the sound effects that I am once again back in the parks. Today I am at DCA because I've been thinking about all those holiday foods since the last time I was here. So, I'm on my way. I already have my list printed out, highlighted my choices for the evening, and I will tell you all about them as we go along. Oh my God, you guys. Woo-hoo! Okay, my first stop was at Favorite Things. And I got they're called ham shanks. And I love pork, okay, in any way, shape, or form, except sausage and ham. I know it sounds bizarre, but then again, I'm not normal. But I had to try these because they look so good on YouTube. I am so glad I did. The meat literally just slides off the bone. It's exquisitely seasoned and has a great sweet sauce that goes over it, along with the grilled pineapple. Mm-mm-mm. So good. And to go along with that, I got the cranberry sangria. Whoa, let me tell you, I took a sip of that first before I started eating. Oh, it's so good. I mean, it's really, really good. And I just took a drink. And it's great for a cold, rainy night like tonight. Right now, it's just barely sprinkling. But it is very cold, at least for Southern California. But this sangria is warming me right up. Okay, now I gotta go finish my food so I can go to the next booth. Woohoo! Okay, I'm back. I just got the shrimp and grits, and it smells very interesting. So, I took a picture of it also to share with you guys. So, I'll be back in a moment. Okay, so to continue, my second stop was at a booth called Holiday Duets. And as I mentioned earlier, I got the shrimp and grits. And it's different than what I was expecting. The only shrimp and grits I've ever had have been with garlic butter. And they're so good. So when I was presented with my cardboard dish, I was surprised to see that there was a red sauce all over everything. It was good. It's very good. And it's spicy. It's got a nice little kick to it. It's actually making my nose run. And it goes great with the cranberry sangria. Now, I have a couple more spoonfuls to devour before I am off in search of my next booth. All right. My next stop was at Grandma's Recipes, I think it's called. Because I had to try the pot roast on a potato bun with horseradish cream. Oh, there's my music. I gotta dance while I eat. Okay, enough foolishness. I'm gonna put this down and actually take my first bite. Right off the bat, the first thing that impressed me. My goodness, this pot roast is so tender. Unbelievable. The roll that it's on is nice and soft. It's not hard. You know, sometimes if bread gets exposed to air, it'll get hard on you. This is perfect. The horseradish cream sauce, personally, I would like it to have more of a kick. It's barely there, horseradish taste. So if you love horseradish like me, you'll wish it was stronger. Oh my goodness, this is so flippin' good. Whew. As I was walking, I noticed that a couple of booths were closed and completely covered with tarp. So I don't know if they ran out of food, which seems highly unlikely to me. But maybe their equipment was malfunctioning. So I hope it's nothing I wanted to try. You can't tell because even the signs are covered. Okay, I forgot to look at the name of the booth, but I got my spicy fried turkey. And something tells me that this is gonna have Tabasco, which I'm not crazy about. But I'm dying to try this, so I've already tasted the pomegranate margarita, and it's got the chipotle salt on the rim. It is good. Let me tell you guys, they do not skimp on the cocktails here at DCA. Yes, they're a little bit pricier, but they are so good and so well made. Okay, time to chow. Side note, what struck me as rather odd, with all this food being offered here, people are lined up at the Corn Dog Castle. That's just odd. Okay, so I am pleasantly surprised with this turkey. This particular piece is not uber juicy and succulent. However, it's not a dried out piece of shoe leather either. And man, it's yummy. Yes, spicy hot, but good hot. I don't know how else to describe it. Man, it's really good. It's a good thing they only give you a little piece too, because I could probably eat 6 servings of this. And it pairs very well with the pomegranate margarita. Mm-mm-mm. Oh. And that smoky chipotle salt on the rim, so good. Okay, I hope you can hear me over the music. The next booth I went to was called A Twist on Tradition. And what I got there was the pozole rojo with hominy polenta. And I'm about to taste it. Oh my. It's very good. Sorry for chewing in your ear, but you know, true Disney people, they want to know. The meat is very, very tender. very well seasoned. Not super spicy at all, but it has a very good flavor to it. Okay, now I'm going to try the hominy polenta. Oh no, that's odd. Now I love hominy, but not so much in this configuration. In fact, I find it a little bland, which is surprising. I mean, everything else tastes so good. It's just bland mush. I mean, I'm still gonna eat it because, you know, it's meat, right? That's too bad. I was looking forward to that. But hey, you know, the bulk of the dish is the pozole, the shredded, I think it's beef, yeah. And that's very good. So I'm gonna sit here. This is my last dish of the night because I have used up all of my tear-off coupons from my Sip and Saver Pass. Of course, I will be coming back to DCA and buying more food, but I'm just gonna pay for it rather than get another Sip and Saver Pass. Because there's a couple things that I would like to have again. Namely, believe it or not, the turkey slider, roast turkey slider was excellent. I really like that. I really like the shrimp and grits. And that pot roast on a bun was very good. And let's not forget, my favorite, the cocktails. Man, pomegranate margarita is delicious. And that cranberry sangria is absolutely delicious. If I was a passenger in a car, I'd get another one to go. I mean, of course, I'd consume it before getting in the vehicle, but yeah, it's that good. It's really good. So I'm gonna meander once I finish eating to see if there are any more booths, because there's plenty of booths listed on this printout that I have, but I haven't seen them all. So I'll keep you posted. Okay, so the rain is coming down. It was a light but steady rain. However, now it's really coming down. I had a struggle to find a place that was covered. So I'm standing under an umbrella right now. People are rushing out of here. Can't say that I blame them. I just stepped in a puddle and now my foot is completely soaked. I really can't complain though. I had a great evening. I really, really, really want to come back. I plan to come back. And I'm going to spend some more money on food, like I said earlier. Because everything is so good. And there's a couple things I want to try again. And there's still more cocktails I want to try. I'm so full right now. I had planned to get an eggnog cocktail. I'm just too full. Woo. Yeah, can't do it. So I think I'm going to call it a night. And I'm probably going to spend 2 hours on the freeway going home, but at least I can listen to podcasts. See y'all next time. Bye.
Right. Thank you so much to Connie for that. You know, I have to say, I love these recordings. I'm really, really looking forward to more of these. I love them. They take me right back into the park. And Connie's also been just helping us and killing it on Instagram for us. We really appreciate Connie. Speaking of Instagram, the Instagram for the show is DizGeekPodcast, at DizGeekPodcast. I'm wrapping everything up because I got to go to bed because, you know, tomorrow's Christmas morning and Santa is coming. You know what I'm saying? I got presents to open. And I'm so excited. So let me read off the Instagrams and the Twitters and all that stuff. Tommy Picks, is at Tommy Picks. Chris is at Diz Chris with a Z. Jess is at Jess Jones 1976. And Connie, of course, is at Mouse Connie. Everybody, thank you so much for hanging out with us this year. This year, the end of the year, marks our 8-year anniversary. So happy 8-year birthday to us. Every December is an anniversary for us. And we are all so appreciative of you guys coming in to listen to us. And I know we're not as active as we used to be. It's just harder now because of the distances and all that stuff. But I honestly love doing the show. I love Disneyland. I love talking about Disneyland. So we're not going anywhere. Things may change. You know, you never know how life goes. We can't get them out as often as I would like to, but we are still going to be doing it. We're going to be killing it in 2019. I'm hoping to do more, but you know, like I said, life is what it is. So we'll do the best we can. But anyway, I just wanted to say we love you guys. Thank you so much. We'll see you in 2019. Bye-bye.